AVtv is a product of the AV Journalism class produced for the students of Amador Valley High School. The views expressed on the show do not represent the views of AVHS teachers, admin, or PUSD personnel.
Good morning, Dons. Today is Friday, November 9th. I'm Cherie.
And I'm Garrett.
Students, don't forget that the District Attorney's Justice Academy applications are due today, Friday, November 9th. Now, we have a segment about the dangers of expo markers.
Almost every classroom on Amador has a whiteboard, supplied with markers that teachers can use whenever they need it. Between schools, universities, and other institutions, roughly 400 million whiteboard markers are thrown out every year in America alone. However, once these markers are thrown away, how do they affect the environment?
On a scale of 1 to 10, expo markers can be pretty harmful, probably on a 6 or 7, just because all the chemicals they release into the environment.
Well, the plastic doesn't decompose ever. So every dry erase marker ever thrown away is still in a landfill somewhere, and that's a lot of volume if you think about how much we go through markers and how many dry erase markers we go through on a campus. And since I had to get some other regular markers and I was annoyed at having to throw them away, I realized I don't need to throw them away, and I found the source that allows us to recycle them for free. So in the teacher mailbox room within the office, there is a large trash bin that says marker recycling only, and so they just dump them in there, and then once I have a large amount of them, I can take them and put them inside of a box, and Crayola allows us to ship it to them for free, and we just tell them how many pounds of markers we're sending, and they will recycle them.
Starting with Ms. Barnett-Dreyfus's bin, we can keep our environment safe one marker at a time.
Now we have a short commercial from the 21st Century Club.
Lunch is over now, so I'm gonna go ahead and throw away my food. Because composting is not that important for the cool kids. Am I right?
No!
Ryan, it's so much easier to compost it.
Cool kids compost.
Here's our last segment for today's show.
Our custodians do a lot for us. From picking up our trash to keeping our school fresh and clean, our custodians make sure that we are always in a pristine environment and able to concentrate on our work. We are also grateful for the hard work they do.
Thank you to Mike Betancourt for being an amazing head custodian. Thank you for keeping our school clean.
Thanks to all of our custodians, because they do a really good job at keeping our whole school nice and clean, and it's not disgusting, doesn't have trash all over the place. They do a really good job, so big thanks.
The custodians are pretty cool, you know, they always pick up after us, and you know, can't take them for granted. It's not an easy job, but I really appreciate
them. Thank you to all your custodians. You guys pick up all of our trash, and I really appreciate that.
Thank you so much to our fabulous custodians for always making sure our school is squeaky clean.
Well, that's all we have for today, Dons.
And remember, it's always a beautiful day here at Amador.
It's a beautiful
for the pledge. I pledge allegiance to the flag of the United States of America and to the republic for which it stands, one nation, under God, indivisible, with liberty and justice for all.